Judd Hagen, you are to hang by the neck until you are dead.
I'll see you in hell.
You, Gabe?
Gabe?
Who'd you figure, Paul?
I wasn't figuring, I was just asking.
Morning, Paul. Paul?
What is it, son?
Is there something worrying you? I mean, are you scared of something? Why don't you tell me what it is?
I don't for certain know. I hear things.
What things?
Well, they got no name. Unless it's Hagen's.
Hagen? We hung that mad dog a month ago.
Yeah, I know that.
Yeah, and I know old man Hagen just about the most vicious man on earth. And I say good riddance.
He was worse than that, Gabe. He thought he was God. Thought he owned his whole territory and everybody in it. Afraid he passed some of that craziness on to his three kids, Nell and Ritt and that hunchback Kirby.
I thought we really put a stop to their doings.
I guess we just made things worse. They're kicking up a storm that makes the old man look like a deacon.
But why are you so scared, Paul?
I'm not scared. Listen, I got worried that... They went into town yesterday. Got Rip married off to their orphan cousin, Julianne. And they got liquored up and they went in the local bank. Robbed it. They killed the two tellers. Got away without a scratch. There's a posse out looking for them. So far, they found nothing but dust.
You don't think they're about to come here, do you, Paul? They're probably on their way to Mexico.
I don't know what they'll do, as crazy as they are. They just might try to send...
Having a bad dream.
Mr. Higgins.
What do you people want?
Well, it ain't a social call.
That's right. That's right. What about them two, Red? Them two.
What do you think now?
You're running things. Just like I said you would. Remember?
That's right, Red. Just like Nell says.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm running things. But it's different.
Is it money you want? Because if it isn't,
yeah, money? Why, Red and Curry went to the bank this day and took all we needed. Didn't we, Curry? Didn't we?
That's right, Julianne. That's right.
Well, if that's enough money in those sacks to burn up half of Mexico.
Hey, yeah. Will you hush up? Julianne, I told you to stay back and take care of the horses.
No. No, I told you to leave my wife alone.
All right. But you tell her. Now she's married into the Hagen family, you're gonna have to obey orders. You understand that? Snip. Hey. Ain't you told her what you did? 1 month ago, Mr. Gately?
Didn't figure there was a need to. She had no part of it.
No need to tell her, huh? Maybe you figure now there is a need, huh?
Listen, Rhett.
Shut up.
Now you stand still and you listen.
Oh, that's right, mister. Just like Rhett says, you listen.
What good can you hope to get out of this?
Good? We don't need no good. We already got that. This is something special, Nell says.
What's the matter, Mr. Gately? Right now, you don't look like that big hero felt. I got that stinking mob all riled up. You got those chicky-livered men too excited. And you goaded them into hanging my pa.
Wasn't only my doing, Nell.
Oh, yes, it was, Mr. Gately. Oh, yes, it was. You wouldn't have dared face my power on the street all by yourself. That wasn't your way. You wouldn't have had the gall. You had to go around hissing poison in people's ears like some slimy old snake. That's what you did. That's how you got that hanging done.
What I did was not for myself. I did it for everybody. If there'd been some established law in Pebble Springs, things might have been different. But there wasn't and there isn't. Your father wouldn't allow no law around here except his own. And that's not right.
That was right. My pa was the law. And the town belonged to us. That's what he told us, so that's what's right. Whatever he said, whatever he did, that's what's right.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's get it over with.
Well, what about them two, Red?
Now, shut up. I'm thinking about them. Now, shut up, Kirby.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's different.
Let's tie him up, Kirby. Let's tie him up.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, I guess we could do that. What do you think, Nell? We wasn't planning on them being here.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right. It's almost as if Pa willed it.
Well, now, what do you mean by that?
Just what I said. It was meant to be. That they'd be here, too. Mr. Gately's an old man. He'd take his life. You ain't taking much. The preaching teacher tells us it's even in the Bible. The sins of the father, they's on the sons. The Gately's a father, and they're his kin.
And now you want to play God.
Hush up. There wouldn't be no fair exchange at all. Old dried up piece of a man in exchange for my pa. That ain't equal. That ain't fair.
No, I don't know now. No, I don't know.
Maybe the memory of our pa don't mean as much to you as you said.
I ain't forgetting. I never been allowed to forget for 1 minute since it happened.
I ain't telling you what you should do. I'm only asking you to remember your pa. Hanging from that beam, hanging down dead. You saw him hanging and swaying and dead. And that's the mangy, lazy, shivering old son of a gun horse that did it. Now, Rip.
God's sake, wait.
Hell fire! Hell nation! Hell, hell! How are we going to make sound horses? Oh, Pa, I want to kill her. Don't let me, Pa. Hold me back. It was right to kill the Gately, but not her. We need her, Pa. We need her kids. They'll be Hagen kids.
All them pretty dollars.
I told you to take care of the horses. I told you to take care of them, didn't I?
I forgot, Neil. I forgot. I didn't want to miss the shooting, Neil.
You forgot?
Yeah.
You forgot?
Yeah.
Oh, quickly, rusty woman. You forgot. Well, from now on, I'm going to make you remember.
I can't see it. I can't tell.
Let me. Oh. I don't think that'll be too bad, Red. Kirby, you and her go on in and take all the food out of that house you can get. Well, go, help, Luck. You cheap little slut. Does it hurt like the devil?
Oh, God, it hurts now.
Thank you.
It's our horses coming back.
You damn fool. It's the posse. They're after your neck. Now get down. Hand me one of them guns.
I left them back at the Gately's.
You damn fool. You jackass damn fool.
Listen.
It's the posse.
Well, old man Gately ain't riding with them no more. No more posses for Gately. Unless they got horses in hell.
They're chasing after our horses.
Well, let's get moving. We gotta get some miles from here.
That's right, Rip. You're right. Rip, we're gonna do whatever you say. Come on now. And you try to keep up with us, Miss Looney Bin. Drag along after everybody ruins you yet.
When our daddy killed the hawk, remember it?
You do. Right.
He said, mind the ways of the wolf. Remember it?
Hey, look! Look, everybody!
Look! Look, Juliet! Hey, Red, look!
I'm on it! I'm
on it! Job! He's stopping you two. Come on. Help me get her up. I swear to my grandma, we found it.
We found it.
Hey, you stuffed the rest of it in this sack.
Yeah.
You need all of it. And hurry up about it, too. We gotta get out of here. We gotta keep moving all the time. Money ain't gonna do us no good if we don't get clear of that posse. All right, let's go. Keep moving. Just keep those feet going. Let's go. Let's go.
Let's go. Take care of them. Oh, yeah. You got to
please. Everybody, come on, please. Come on. We got it.
I wish I had me a big, ripe, juicy tomato. There you go. In quarter stop. There you go. There you go.
Said there'd be water here, Carrie. You said there'd be water
No.
Just like all the promises. Some husband you are.
You leave him be, will ya?
Sure are, Dan Kirby, leaving all that food in one time.
Well, I guess the rest of you forgot just as much as me. All right, I left it behind. Now, how long you gonna keep harping at me, huh?
I'm gonna keep harping at you, Gary. The food and water, that's when.
Oh, please leave me alone.
You said there'd be water here.
There is.
Well, where is it?
Somewhere.
Wait, you hush up. You save your sweat. There's no yapping anymore. Just keep quiet and keep moving. Keep your feet calm. One after the other.
Kirby's the only one left on his feet. The only one of any use at all. Ritz too sick. She's too silly.
Oh, furry-faced fool, that's what she is. And that pure pink parasol. If she don't settle down, I'm gonna take and poke that thing right through her gizzard. Just stick with me, Pa. Till we don't need her anymore. We'll make it. Kirby! Let's try for some water here. Just take pieces of like that. You get that one. Now start digging.
You just get up and die and get it over with.
Why, you skinny.
See? See what I mean? See what I mean?
Gotta get Ritz some food, too, somehow, Nell. He's gotta have some. I don't know, Nell. I don't know.
You're not supposed to know. You're supposed to dig.
Promises.
just promises. Fancy clothes. Fine food. Servants to serve, not fair at all. Never wished for more than to a pretty girl. Ever.
No use, huh, now? There's no water here. It's no use. We'll never get to that Mexico the way Red is. And look at Julianne.
Well, shoot. Keep going if I have to whip her to it.
If we turn back, maybe.
If we turn back, maybe. We are not turning back.
Oh, please, I can't go no more now.
Oh, quit it. Quit it now. I'm getting a full-size pain in the back of my head listening to you two whine. I'll quit that whining.
There's no water here. It's no use.
Look at her. Look at a cow. Look at all that. Looks like a whole mess of long yellow worms crawling right out of her skull. Why don't you chop all that off? You're gonna get it full of bugs out here.
Where are we headed, Nell? Where are we headed?
Get up!
Red, I'll help you.
Easy.
That's it. Here, I'll get it.
Kirby, you get him on. Easy now. Easy, boy.
Look, now.
Look, Julianne. Hey, Red, look.
We'll head for the house.
Anybody home?
only him.
She's just a tore loose shingle flapping in the wind. You go get him, Miss I. Let's go.
Come on, Rip. I got you. Some brush to make Ritz's bed.
I want to make his own bed.
No!
No!
Let
no!
Me be one,
no!
Oh. Never hurt anybody at all. Nice
oh,
little
Harry,
thing.
Harry, why is Bill always picking on me that way for? What'd I ever do to her?
Well, there's no food, and...
She didn't used to be that way, Kirby. She was always playing up to me. Always telling me about the fine things we was gonna have after my married Rip.
Well, Nell says things will be fine when we get to that Mexico. Once Ritz back on his feet.
It's a dead man, Kirby, and you're a fool if you believe any different.
Don't you talk like that. Don't you ever talk like that.
Oh, Kirby, we ought to leave him here. He's just holding us up and all for nothing.
Julianne, I swear, you've been touched.
much as I still did. Kirby, you go take that axe and go out, kill the world.
But now, how will we move Red?
If you don't do as I say, there'll be nothing to move.
Real nice if you
like this. Hey, yeah. You can come on. Come on. I don't want to hurt you. Rick needs food. Nelson, I gotta do it. I don't want to, Purdy. No. I won't hurt you too much.
Kirby. You want to help me put on my new dress, Kirby? Oh, don't look then, silly. You could read, Kirby.
I can.
What do you keep looking at that book for, stupid?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
Kirby, you and me could be on our way.
Red ain't fit to move.
That's right. He ain't. But you and me are, Kirby. There's a lot of dollars in them sacks, Kirby.
Yeah.
There's a lot of living in them sacks, Kirby.
A lot of dying, too.
Go someplace so far where nobody would ever find us.
I don't think Ritt will be able to.
Forget about Ritt. Ritt's a dead man, Kirby. I saw his eyes when that bullet hit him. They went all white. It's just a matter of time now. Then with Ritt gone, Kirby, you and me won't have a chance with that money. Nell will take it all for herself. Don't you understand that, Kirby?
You sure talk crazy sometimes, Julianne.
Why don't you listen to me, Kirby?
She's no good. She's no good to any of us.
Run. Run home.
Rick. Rick, you're dreaming.
We should have run home, Nell. They're catching up to us, I know it.
No, Rick. Ain't nothing.
They're coming, I tell you.
You gotta lay still, Rick.
Why? Why do I gotta lie still? Now, Kirby, you tell me.
I don't listen to him, Rick. You're just fine. Come on, get up and jump around.
What's Julianne trying to tell me, Kirby?
Nothing, Rick. Nothing. You gotta take it easy, that's all.
What? Come on, Rick. Get up and you and me'll do a little dancing. This is all wedding day and I'm all dressed up like a bride.
Will you hike up?
You leave her be now. Now you leave her be. Kirby, why didn't you tell me the truth about this?
Well, Nell thought that we...
Nell thought that. Nell's been doing a lot of thinking lately, hasn't she?
She's been doing all the thinking. Ain't you, Nell?
Maybe Julianne's right.
She's right.
I've been doing the thinking. Somebody's got to think for the Hagen family. I swore on my pa's hanging head to keep the Hagen name alive, to make the Hagen family big and strong like Pa was.
Some family, a dead man, a cripple, and an old maid!
She just talks now.
You must have planned the whole thing, didn't you, Nell? You talked Julianne into marrying me? Well, why? Now I want to know why.
She can give us children. That's the only reason. She don't have to be smart to do that. Any old rump-sprung sow can do that. But we need them children. My pa's their grandpa. He'll still be alive. And in them. Ain't nothing in her head but jelly. But the Hagen blood, your blood, will be so strong, it'll wash out all the weak part from her. And they'll be men. They'll be big men. They'll be Hagen men. Big men, full of strength, full of force, full of heat, full of power, like Pa was.
Well, it don't matter how I come by her. She's mine now.
Yeah, that's right. She's yours. But hers belongs to us.
Stick together, Julianne. The four of us. We're all we got.
Thank you.
You know something, Julianne? It says in here, somewhere, that we can be saved. I remember that.
Saved? For what?
Well, you know, saved.
Oh. Why don't you come in here with me?
What for?
Well, stupid. We could talk.
Ain't nothing to talk about.
And then we could listen.
Listen to what?
Listen to the moonlight bouncing off a rotten carcass. Kirby. Kirby, please come in here with me. We can have fun, Kirby. Nice fun, Kirby. Come on in here, Kirby. Please come in here with me. That's a boy. What are you laughing at, Kirby? What you laughing at, Kirby?
I was listening to the moonlight bouncing off a rotten carcass like you said, Julianne.
Thank you.
What are you doing in there anyhow? Nasty, nasty. Come on in the house. Be quiet. Your husband needs his sleep.
We should have took him to a doctor right off, Mel. Our brother's dying, he...
He's gonna live. He's gotta live. Deserting the family.
Family, the family. What's so great about the name of Hagen anyhow? You know what I wish, Nell? That I'd never been married into this cursed hell family.
And I'm gonna tell you once. Not after that. You can put that money back. Because if you don't...
You know something, Nell? All of a sudden, you don't scare me anymore.
And if you take off, you ain't gonna be a Hagen anymore.
Well, that's just fine. Because, well, I was planning on taking a new name anyway. I need a name that I can use at parties. Melody. Oh,
Oh, I like that. Julie Ann Melody.
Well, what are you waiting for? Miss Melody. There she goes. No, sir. No, ma'am. I ain't gonna stop you. Count on you, huh?
Yeah,
no. I don't rightly know what I'd do without you, Kirby. You're always right there when I need you. Well, I need you now, Kirby. I got a job for you. It's a job that only you can do. Come on. Out there, Kirby.
She's run off. She's run off, Mel. What'll we do?
We can't let her go. She's gonna tell where we're at.
I'll go fetch her.
That's right, Kirby. Take that axe with you.
The axe? What for, Nell?
He's deserting the family.
I'll bring her back.
I don't want her back. She's bad, ain't she, Kirby? She's bad.
Yes, but I...
That's right, Kirby. You take that axe, you go out there, and do what has to be done.
No, please. I can't do it now. I can't.
What are you afraid of?
The book. It says we can be saved. It ain't too late now.
You do it, Kirby. You're stronger than anybody. You got more guts than anybody.
Are you sure now? Are you sure? Is this what it says in the book now?
That's right, Kirby. Take that axe with you.
Thank you.
what you doing up? You killed yourself.
Where's Julianne? Where's Kirby?
Out there. Outside in the yard.
No. They ain't out there at all, are they?
What do you say that for?
Because you've done something to them, and I know it.
Well, you're talking sick, Rick. Why would I do something to them?
Because you're evil, Nell Hagen. Oh, I've been blind with all your talk about the Hagens and the rights we have to everything. You blinded all three of us.
Careful, that wound is deep.
I know it's deep. I can feel it now real bad. I've been fighting to live. I've been fighting so hard. And then all of a sudden, deep down in sleep somewhere, I quit fighting. I got no right to live after what I done. There ain't none of us got any right to live.
How did you lay down? Grip, please.
For the last time, where is Julianne and where is Kirby?
She took off. She's ran away. Your prissy Julianne, your wife. She's ran away. And she left you here to die. I sent Kirby to catch you.
You should let her get away. Then she'd be safe. Now she's gonna die. Just like the rest of us.
Well, now you give up, too. Die like the rest of us. Now, you listen to me, Red. We ain't gonna die. We're not gonna die. We're Hagens. We're all the Hagens that's left. And we're gonna live till there's more Hagens to live. And they're gonna live till there's more Hagens to live. And they'll live till there's more Hagens to live.
yet?
No. Not yet.
Well, what's keeping him?
You shouldn't be on your feet. You hear me?
It don't matter. I just want to see Julianne.
She's dead. I sent Kirby to kill her. She had it coming to her. She deserted the family.
Rick, don't do that. You're going to kill yourself.
You got to stop Kirby. Somebody's got to stop
Kirby. You got to stop. You're going to kill yourself.
Kill myself. You don't want me to do that, do you now? You want me to live so I can breathe some more Higgins into the world. That's what you want, isn't it, now? Well, I ought to kill you now. Only you don't deserve to die so easy. Kirby and me, we deserve it. But not you.
That's right. You're right, Rit. Not me. There ain't no blood on my hands. I ain't guilty of nothing. I didn't do the killing. You and Kirby did the killing. Just like I told you. Not me. You did it. Ain't no blood on my hands. I didn't do no killing. Not me.
There's no blood on your hands. It's in your very soul. Now you get up. And you stop Kirby. Now. Now.
You go, Pa. Let's go. Pa. My name. Hagen. Hagen. Yes, go.
Pop? Yes, go, Pop. Yes, go. Pop. Yes, go.
Is this what it says in the book now? Is this what it says in the book now?
Get away from me now. Get away from me now.